In this video, I want to show you an example of how to calculate a spending variance. So a spending variance is the difference between the actual amount of an expense and the amount that the expense should have been according to the company's flexible budget. So let's take a consulting firm, and let's say that they put together a planning budget at the beginning of the period and they thought they were going to have 100 consulting projects. And so then they had their budgeted revenue and then some budgeted expenses based on the 100 consulting projects they were expected to have. But then it turns out the actual amount of consulting projects they have was 130. So if you remember from our video of putting together a flexible budget, we have to adjust the planning budget to say what should all these expenses have been, assuming that we had 130 projects instead of 100. Because it makes sense if we have 30 more projects than what we thought we were going to have, that we would have more wages expense, have more supplies expense, and so forth, right? So we make our flexible budget, and that's basically here's what the budget should have been given that we had 130 projects. Okay, so here are what our expenses should have been for each of these expenses. So we're going to take these expenses here and we're going to compare them to the actual results. So let's just do this one by one. So we'll take the entertainment expense and we say, okay, the actual amount was $49,000. According to the flexible budget, it should have been 26. So we've got a $23,000 unfavorable variance there. That's an unfavorable spending variance as we spent $23,000 more or incurred in terms of our entertainment expenses than what we should have per the flexible budget. So we should look into that. For our wages, we should have done $82,000, but we only did $79,000. So that's actually a favorable variance of $3,000. So I'll just put a little F for favorable. And then for our supplies, we actually incurred $13,200 of a supplies expense, but it should have been $13,000. So we have $200 unfavorable spending variance. And then for utilities, we had $3,100 and it should have been $3,007. So that's going to be a $93 unfavorable spending variance. Rent, $18,000, so it's zero. There is no spending variance there. The same for insurance. The actual equals what it is for the flexible budget. The same for our business license. And then for the company car, we have, let's see here. So the actual expense was $22,000, but it should have been $15,750. So that is $6,250 higher was the actual amount of the expense for the company car than what it should have been. So that's unfavorable. Now, so we've identified here a number of variances. These are all spending variances, okay? So these spending variances, now you might be wondering, you might look at the supplies, for example, the 200 unfavorable, and you might say, okay, well, is that because we paid too much for supplies? Did we pay too much? Did we get a bad price? Or did we use too many supplies? Did we use too much? And so is there, who are we up to talk to about this? Should we talk to the purchasing agent, the person who's buying the supplies, and say, hey, why did we pay too much? Or should we talk to the people actually using the supplies and say, why did we use too much? And we're gonna break that out. There's actually a way with variance analysis where we can get into, okay, did we pay too much or use too much? We're gonna get more in depth with that when we go into variance analysis.